Okay, let's go. Salut!
Hi, I'm Alex, Iman's head of production. Every time the conversation of starting a vlog pops up, he always postpones.
So you think we should start the vlogs?
No, next week.
Why?
Because I'm busy.
Well, weeks go by and a lot of cool moments are shared.
And then now being able to take care of my mom and of course being here. This watch, yeah, it's cool, my bro. Like, your love. You're my brother for real. On that bullshit.
Sorry, I'm a cunt, I know.
Yeah, you are. For not starting the vlog sooner. Therefore, I'm making the executive decision to start these vlogs today.
Yes, boss.
No, not today.
We have to.
Not today, bro.
Now we have to.
Next week.
Damn. Look at this. Must be nice. Why haven't you been at the villa?
What are you talking about? I literally have given up my fucking villa for the second week in a row. I've given up my master bedroom, and I'm out here hiding away.
Oh, hiding. Well, looks like a tough life, hey?
Okay, do you see any
room service?
Wow.
Two glasses. Who was here last night?
What do you want from me?
We're starting the vlog. Ladies and gentlemen, episode 1, Iman Gazi. Yes, sir.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't like loud techno music at 3 a.m. while I'm trying to sleep. So, yeah, last week I had like some of my friends from London and Europe over for my birthday week. Then we had like 2 days of calm. Then I have some of my friends from the States now. So, yeah, I've just been hiding out here for 2-3 weeks.
Apparently you got a pillow menu. Where's this pillow menu?
Look, it's on set.
That's actually ridiculous.
Pillow menus are common, bro. It's not... What?
No, they're not.
What do you mean, no, they're not?
Wait, what are you...
It's finally working.
Yeah. Is he finally working now?
I'm always working.
Been doing nothing. Just going out, partying, girls.
Oh, thank you. That's the first time you've ever done that.
What? Oh, normally you just reach into my humidor and just take my most expensive bahike, but that's okay. It's fine.
Well, since you've been exploiting me.
You're moving to Dubai to a 6-bedroom beachfront villa.
I'm getting underpaid.
You cost me $4,000 a month in just cigars.
They're gonna get to the border and they're gonna look at him and be like, are you with this man? Are you sure?
Is he trafficking you?
Your man literally asked for both my passports.
This is true, yeah, I do have them. So, I was telling Axis like a month ago, whatever, we had a party, there was like maybe 20 girls. He was getting a little too like, you know, worked up, right? So I told him, I pulled him to the side. I was like, listen, Alex, there was once two bulls on a hill. And there was a valley, and there was 20 cows. So the young bull goes, let's run down there and fuck one of them. And the old bull goes, no, let's walk down and fuck them all.
Wow.
Do you understand the lesson in that?
I do.
Finish my sentence. In the end,
she grabs me by. We fuck them all.
Big day.
Comeback season?
No.
Wait.
Comeback season?
Wolves vlog starting.
What's the plans for the day?
Drive Chapman's cool, ice cream place.
Yeah, and then penguins.
Oh, they want to go penguins.
We need to take them to penguins.
Be honest, you low-key excited for the penguins?
Bro, I honestly no.
Why?
He's an alpaca sort of guy.
I'm more of an alpaca kind of guy.
Whoa, yeah, look at me dead in my eyes. I know that you know that a nigga ain't lying. Too much respect, all of my shorty BDs, they know not to try. Too much respect, I used to hand out CDs before they would buy it. Whoa, she love me so much, it seem like she buys. Niggas don't know how I live, but that's cause they live at the high. Ay. 4L steps, he ain't stepping on shit till it's quiet. He brought me the money sealed up, I still had to count it, I cannot just hide. Whoa, yeah, let's have sex in the bank. Telling her open a safe. I hate a privileged rapper who don't even know what it take. The diamonds they hit like a rainbow. That's cause the necklace of Frank. Purr.
Hey, you got this.
Come here.
This guy's on the walkway. Shortcut.
Sit down.
In the spine, let's do it. I hate a privileged rapper that ain't had a hit since he signed. Do it. Niggas be full of excuses, act like they taking their time. Wow, wow, wow.
Adam, you put those shoes through the ringer, hey?
Alright, that feeds to the biggest nightclubs.
He gets his money worth.
Alright, that feeds to the biggest nightclubs.
Why? Guys, you can see I'm not made for this life. We're hiking up Lion's Head, which is that right there. We're going to the very top of it. It's probably one of the best views in Cape Town.
Thank you so much.
No worries, bro.
Cheers. Have a good day.
We did last time with the weighted vest, right?
Yeah.
Is this what it costs?
Cheese!
Light work, baby.
We made it.
We got there. Got there and then... Well, half of us made it.
Woo! I was back here for security reasons.
A week.
$600?
$600. Pink.
No, 500.
Yellow.
Pink.
You said yellow.
Pink.
Yellow.
$600!
Yellow.
Pink.
Yellow.
Pink.
Yellow goes with some of my outfits. Bro, I don't wear pink in general. Now you want my fingers to be pink.
Yeah.
Nah.
Bro, you switched up, bro.
Four fingers just doesn't...
Hey, 2 weeks ago, he knifed at that, bro. 2 weeks ago, since he made that sheet money, he changed.
Big day.
Big day.
We got a big day today. We got big plans. We're going to the winery soon. We're going to go pick up everyone, head over there. We had a long night last night. I'm not doing too hot right now. You will see him on TV any given Sunday when the Super Bowl and drive off. Go all the way up. I think I need a coffee. Once I have a coffee, I'll be good. And then we'll get back to what we're good at.
Decided to finally leave his room and come join us on his own vlog.
Yeah, but Adam was... I told Adam, just do the vlog for me.
I'm the narrator for this vlog.
He's feeling a little down and out, though. He's been pissed on twice in the last 12 hours.
Yeah. Can you please elaborate on that?
It was just the dog that... went past me and pissed on my leg when I was walking
like
in the
objectifying
street.
A woman as a dog.
No, you're trying to call
women dog now.
This is all getting bleeped in the fucking video.
Wow.
It was a fucking stray dog in the street that walked past me and pissed on me.
I thought you were
an actual...
I knew he was a misogynist.
An actual physical dog.
I knew it.
A dog on the road that was walking.
He's playing this nice guy bullshit.
I'm done.
I knew he was a misogynist.
I'm done. You can't even sit in peace. Cause all of these niggas be on you.
I'm just saying I can be, yeah, the one that you call and you talk to, girl. I'll share my world with you. If you're gonna waste your time, yeah, then waste your time with me. I mean, honestly.
Oh, she's got one.
What up, homie? What up, homie?
Security was like, "What are you doing?" And I was like, "I'm bringing it back to his friends."
Someone take a photo of me holding my
phone. Okay, girls, time for the real shit.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed this first vlog. As you can tell, I am not cut out for this whole vlogging thing. I have been living this life for a fair few years now. And, you know, if any of you guys follow me on Instagram, you'll see I do some photo dumps, you know, once a month, once every few months, something like that. But to have a camera actually follow me around in my intimate life, it's definitely not something I'm used to. I definitely am super public, but also very, very private at the same time, especially with the people that I'm around. You know, one thing about me is I will never repost anyone's story because I don't like people knowing who I'm with. I mean, it's crazy. If I tag myself with a person, then that person will start getting 100, 200, 300 DMs, basically asking them to tell me to respond to their DM. And ladies and gents, I try my absolute best to engage with you guys as much as possible. I really do. But my request as I start vlogging, start sharing more of my personal life is my guy friends, my girlfriends, please refrain from reaching out to them, telling them to tell me to respond to you. Like, it's just... I would like an air of privacy there. But with that little caveat out the way, I also want to preface by saying that you guys will see a lot of opulence. You guys will see a lot of what to you might seem so crazy, but I guess for me has just become so normal. From 2016 up until really around like 2020, early 2021, my life consisted of deep focused work at the desk. Really the last 2 years, I get to my desk and I realize I don't necessarily have anything to do. Everything I have to do is on one of these, and I have a few more of these, but various different phones for different purposes, for different businesses, for different problems, challenges, whatever that may arise. But the one thing, as I said, I want to make very, very clear, and you guys can even see in this vlog, a lot of times I will hide away when there's fun stuff. I will hide away. I'll wake up early. I'll get to work. I don't think you guys understand. I literally sleep with one eye open these days. So while I'm in a funny position where between all of my companies, I have over 150 employees, so I don't have anything really to do at my desk. My entire life consists of maintaining company culture, hiring the right people, speaking with my leadership team and my different companies, speaking with my family office and my CFO to make sure the finances are correct. We've got money in the right places, that money is growing. And apart from that, just being on my phone, quite frankly, 24/7 these days. So I want to make something very clear. When you guys see this opulence, when you see this lifestyle, understand that for me, it's just, I guess, normal life. But I'm in a situation where I work harder than ever. And I guess now watching over this vlog and realizing that, oh, wow, like, I guess my day-to-day life just seems so normal to me. All this stuff seems so normal while I'm doing it, but now looking back, I'm like, oh wow, like this is not normal life for most people. But as cool as watching these vlogs are, I want you to go back to 2016 on my main YouTube channel, scroll all the way back and just watch for years and years as I built my business. I sacrificed blood, sweat, tears, day in, day out. And the funny thing is, I do the exact same thing, if not even more. The only difference is these days I have a bunch more high-level dudes around me, a bunch more women around me, and rather than taking the tube, we jet around the world, and it's a beautiful experience, but never, ever, ever take it for granted that work is the only thing that keeps you there. And that is why out of 100 people, only 10 will make it, and out of those 10, only one will stay in that position. Because the scariest place to be is at the top, because when you're at the top, the only way is down. So I really just wanted to preface that before you see all these crazy experiences that I haven't been vlogging for all these years and think that you're gonna get to a point in life where you can just relax. Trust me, when you get to this position is when you need to work the absolute hardest. I hope you guys enjoy the next video, and I promise I will try my absolute best in the next one to stop being so shit at vlogging and stop running away from my own vlog and actually interact and engage with you guys. As I said, a camera in my face all the time is not normal to me. So I'm just trying to adjust, and we'll see if I can do any better in the next vlog. So I'll see you there.